Okay, so today we'll start with node analysis. So till last lecture we have completed with DC analysis using mesh analysis. So all four cases we have dealt with. We have discussed with type 1 problem, type 2 problem, type 3 and type 4. Type 1 problem is only independent voltage source along with resistances are there present in the network. Type 2 problem is along with voltage source there will be current source present in the network, but current source will be at the outer loop or outside of the meshes. So that is not common between any two meshes. So that is type 2 problem. In type 3, along with independent current and voltage sources, there may be dependent voltage or current sources. So if dependent voltage or current sources are there, that will become type 3 problem. And in type 4 problem, the independent current source, it is common between two meshes. So that forms a super mesh problem. Okay, so all these four types we have dealt with for DC analysis. So mesh analysis is over. Now we'll start our discussion with node analysis. In node analysis also, we'll deal with different types of problems. Type 1 problem will be the same, having voltage source and resistances. So it is a simple type of network. So node analysis type 1 problem will be voltage source and resistances. In type 2 problem, again current source will be added in that. So if current source is added, that will become a type 2 problem. Then type 3 problem, as usual, if dependent voltage or current sources are added, that will become type 3 problem. And type 4 problem, similar to that of super mesh, here the concept of super node will be there. So how super node will be formed, that we'll discuss at the time of solving that particular type of problem. So before starting tackling any type of problem in node analysis, first, what do you mean by node analysis? In mesh analysis, we have made use of KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, and we have formed a closed loop. So after forming a closed loop, we have applied Kirchhoff's voltage law to that particular mesh. So that was in mesh analysis. In node analysis, exactly opposite you have to deal with. So that means you will, instead of using Kirchhoff's voltage law, you will use Kirchhoff's current law. And instead of a mesh, you will tackle it at a node. So first you have to find how many nodes are there in the network. So if this is the mesh, this is the network given to you. In this network, for mesh analysis, you can see that there are three meshes, mesh 1, mesh 2 and mesh 3. And for nodal analysis, you have to find how many nodes are there. So first of all, what do you mean by a node or a junction? So junction or node means where it is the junction at which at least three or more than three branches are meeting. So how many points are there in the circuit having three or more branches? This is one, from where R1 branch, this R3 branch and R2 branch, three branches are coming. So this is one node, this is another node, one branch, second branch and third branch. So three branches are meeting. So meaning is that the current has to be divided. And current can be divided only if there are three branches meeting at a junction. So from one, current will come, and in two branches, current can be divided. So this is the concept of a node. So these are the two nodes in this network, and one reference node you have to form. That is the ground terminal, which we are calling it in our electronic system. So this terminal, which is common to all, that particular junction, you can say that it is a reference node or ground node, which is usually connected to ground. So after forming these three nodes, one will be one first junction, second junction, and a reference junction. After forming these junctions, you have to allocate the voltages. So first apply voltage to this. Let us say, we'll say it is a V1 volt at junction 1. Here at junction 2, V2 volt is there. And for reference voltage, it is 0 volt. Then you have to assume the directions of current at this junction. So all the time we'll assume that currents are going away from this junction. So outward direction will assume. You can assume even inward directions. But if the directions of current we are assuming same, we can add them together and equal to zero. So for writing the KCL equation, Kirchhoff's current law equation, it will be easy if you will assume only one direction of current. So here we'll assume outward direction of current as positive, and then sum all these currents equal to zero for this junction. Then for these currents, find out the values of currents using Ohm's law. So simply Ohm's law, let us say for through this R1, through this branch, let us say I1 current is flowing. So how to find this I1 current? I1 current you can find using Ohm's law, that is VB minus this VX upon R1 will be the current flowing through this R1 when it is outside, outward direction. Through through this R3 resistance, again let us say I2 current is flowing. So how to calculate that current value? VB minus this reference node potential, which is at 0 volt. So VB minus 0 divided by R3 will be the current flowing through this R3. If you want to find current flowing through R2, though current is flowing in this direction, so that I3 will become VB minus VC divided by R2 will be this current. Now sum all these currents and equate it to 0. So this will give you equations in terms of VB and VC, or this voltage is V1 and V2. So in terms of V1 and V2, you have got one equation. Similarly, apply KCL at this node to form second equation. Then as you have got two equations, two unknowns, you can solve them and get the values of VB and VC. And then ultimately you can find out the current or voltage through any branch or across any branch. So this is shown I1, I2, I3, three currents. Then sum these three, find out value of I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6. This I3, you can assume it same here as I3, or for this junction, instead of this, you can assume for this junction I1, I2, I3 currents. For this junction, you assume I4, I5 and I6 currents. You can assume different values of currents even, and all are going outside. Okay. Then how to find this? Any current you can find by with the difference between these two potentials divided by the value of resistance. So this node analysis procedure, what are the steps? In short, we'll revise it. Select a node as the reference node. Assign the voltages V1, V2 up to Vn for all the nodes. Up to Vn minus 1 only. And the nth node will be the reference node, that is V0, which is the reference node having 0 volt. then apply KCL to each of the n minus 1 non-reference nodes using Kirchhoff's current law. Find out all the currents, express them as a summation equal to zero. Then solve these resulting simultaneous equations to obtain the unknown node voltages. And after getting the node voltages, use these node voltages to find any branch current. Okay. So, typical circuit for node analysis is this, or otherwise, instead of going for this, we'll straight away come to a problem. This is the numerical given to you. Using node analysis, calculate the current through 3 ohm resistor for the network given in figure. So in this figure, you have given a network for which we want to find current through this 3 ohm resistor. And we can assume that this is one node as there are 3 branches. This is another node. There are 3 branches. So this is first junction. This is second junction. And your reference junction is here. Now, how to tackle this problem? I'll share my screen. We'll try to use some different method today. And we'll find out whether it will suit us or not. So is my screen visible to you? Avi?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we'll use some different method. I'll solve the numerical with handwritten solution. And let us find whether you can understand it better by this way or in PPTs. So that will follow any one of these. Okay.
So let us start solving this numerical with node analysis. So this network is given to you. 6 volt battery, 6 ohm resistor, 3 ohm resistor, 5 volt battery, 2 ohm resistor, 4 ohm resistor, 4 ohm resistor, and 10 volt battery. Using node analysis, we have to calculate current through 3 ohm resistor. So we want to find current flowing through this 3 ohm resistor. So in node analysis, first you have to find the junctions or nodes. So this is one node. Node is defined as having 3 branches, or a junction of 3 branches forms a node. So this is node 1, let us say. This is node 2, so we'll mark it as node 1. This is node 2. The voltage at this node 1, let us assume it as V1 volt. At node 2, voltage available is, let us say, V2, and one more reference node you have to consider. Say this is the reference node or a ground node referred as V0, having potential 0 volts. Okay, now find out the directions, or assume the directions flowing outwards for each junction and in all branches. Let us say this current is I1 flowing outward, this current is I2 flowing outward, and this current is I3 flowing outward. For this junction, let us assume another current. This is I4, this is I5, and this is I6. So all currents, we have assumed it, they are moving away from the junction, so that we can apply KCL by summing all the currents. Algebraic sum of currents is equal to zero. So if we are assuming all the currents are outgoing, you can take them on one side and other side will be equal to zero. That's why we have assumed it like that. So now let us tackle the problem. So first, applying KCL at junction J1. So we'll write applying KCL at junction 1. So at first junction, we are going to apply KCL. So the current I1 plus I2 plus I3 equal to 0. Now in order to find I1, you consider this path. So it is V1 minus 6 upon 6 will be the current I1. So V1 minus 6 upon 6 is I1. Now for I2, it is V1 minus 0 upon 3. So that is V1 upon 3. So we'll add all these currents. Now I3, I3 is V1 plus 5 and minus V2. So V1 minus V2 and plus 5, because the direction of current is from negative terminal of battery to positive terminal. So it is rise in potential. So we will consider its sign as positive. So V1 minus V2 plus 5 divided by 2 will be current I3. So V1 minus V2 plus 5 divided by 2. So this summation of I1 plus I2 plus I3, it is equal to 0. Now you take LCM for this. So it is 6. For this you have to multiply by 1. For this you have to multiply by 2. For these elements numerator you have to multiply it by 3. So it will be V1 minus 6 plus twice of V1, then plus thrice of V1 minus 3 V2 plus 15 divided by 6 is equal to 0. Now take this 6 on that side, so that, and club all the terms of V1 together, V2 together, and constants on another side. So this will result 6V1 minus 3V2 is equal to minus 9. Let us say this is equation number 1. So I hope you got the procedure for this. I'll revise it again. So applying KCL at junction 1, at this particular junction we have applied KCL. So what KCL states? All the algebraic sum of all the currents in that junction is 0. So we have assumed all the currents flowing outwards. So I1 plus I2 plus I3 will be equal to 0. Now for I1, we have calculated it from this. V1 minus 6 divided by 6 is the value of I1. For I2, it is V1 minus 0 divided by 3. So that is V1 by 3. And for I3, V1 minus V2 and plus 5 divided by this 2 ohm resistor. So we have added I1, I2 and I3. Then for simplification purpose, we have taken LCM of this, and the numerator terms we have clubbed together, V1, V2 and constants on another side. So in this way we have got equation number 1. Now for getting second equation, we have got two variables or two unknowns, V1 and V2. So we must get two equations. So for getting another equation, we have to apply KCL at junction J2 or junction 2. So applying KCL at junction 2. So at second junction, we are going to apply KCL. So if you are applying KCL, we have assumed the direction again, current's direction outward, I4, I5 and I6. So summation of I4 plus I5 plus I6 will be equal to 0. Now for calculating I4, it is V2 minus 5 minus V1 divided by 2. So value of I1 will be V2 minus V1 minus 5 divided by 2 will be value of I4. Then for I5, it is V2 minus 0 upon 4. So it will be V2 upon 4. And for I6, third current, it is V2 minus 10 divided by 4. So V2 minus 10 divided by 4, this is equal to 0. So we have summed three currents, I4, I5 and I6. We have calculated value of I4 as V2 minus V1 and minus 5 divided by 2. For I5, V2 minus 0 divided by 4. So V2 by 4. Then for I6, it is V2 minus 10 divided by 4. And we have clubbed, we have summed all the currents I4, I5, I6 equal to 0. Now again simplify this. For simplification purpose, take LCM, multiply this by 2, multiply this by 1, multiply this by 1, so that it will be twice V2 minus twice V1 minus 10 plus V2 plus V2 minus 10 divided by 4 is equal to 0. Take 4 on that side and club all the terms of V1 together, V2 together and constants on another side. So if you will take 4 on that side, it will become 0 and the only one term is there for V1. So minus 2 V1, V2 will club it as 4 V2 and equal to 20. Let us say this is equation number 2. I hope you have understood how we have calculated equation number 2 and 1. So applying KCL at junction 1, we have got equation 1. And applying KCL at junction 2, we have got equation 2. Now, in the same manner as we have solved these two equations simultaneously in mesh analysis, you have to solve these two equations simultaneously with in this nodal analysis also to find values of V1 and V2. So, I have told you in the first lecture that there are three methods for calculating the values of V1 and V2. Either you can solve these equations simultaneously, that is first method, or you can use Cramer's rule, or directly you can use calculator. So let us see all the methods one by one. Say first we'll solve these equations simultaneously. So if you want to solve these equations simultaneously, I'll multiply equation number 2 by a factor 3 and I'll add it with equation number 1. So what it will result, I have multiplied this equation by 3 so that I want to cancel this term V1. So if I'll multiply this by 3, it will become minus 6V1 and in equation 1 there is 6V1 term is there. So if we'll add these two equations after multiplying this by 3, the V1 term will be cancelled in this and only V2 term and constant will be there. So this equation will become minus 6V1 plus 12V2 equal to 60. This was my second equation, which I have multiplied it by 3, and this is the modified equation. Let us say it is equation number 3, and first equation I'll rewrite again. So it is 6V1 minus 3V2 is equal to minus 9. This is my first equation. Then I'll add these two equations so that this minus 6V1 and plus 6V1, these two terms will be cancelled to each other. This 12V2 minus 3V2, so it will be remain 9V2 is equal to 51. So V2 is equal to 51 by 9. It is equal to, I'll just use a calci. So 51 divided by 9, so it is giving me 5.667. So 5.667 is the answer for V2. So this many volts. Now I'll substitute this value of V2 in equation 1. So if you will substitute value of V2 in equation 1, then it will give you value of V1 as V1 is equal to, it is minus 9 plus 3 times V2, which is 5.667, divided by 6, which is coming it out as 3 into 5.667. Calci, it is 17. So minus 9 plus 17 divided by 6, it is coming out as 1.33 volts. So this is value of V1. So I have got value of V1 and V2 by using the method of simultaneously solving the equation. Now I'll solve this same equations using Cramer's rule. So if I want to solve it by Cramer's rule, I have to write these equations in matrix form. So I'll write all these equations in matrix form as this matrix of coefficients of V1 and V2 is equal to this matrix of constant. So for first equation, in first equation the coefficient of V1 is 6. I'll write it here. For coefficient of V2 is minus 3. I'll write it here. So this will be like this: 6V1 minus 3V2 is equal to minus 9. So constant I'll write here. Then from second equation, the coefficient of V1 is minus 2, coefficient of V2 is 4, and constant is 20. So this equation 2 is like this: minus 2V1 plus 4V2 is equal to 20. So I have written this matrix equation for this from this equation number 1 and 2. Now using Cramer's rule, you can solve this in this way. If you want to find value of V1, V1 is equal to determinant of this coefficient of V1 and V2 at denominator 6, minus 3, minus 2, 4, this determinant, and you have to replace this first column by these constants at numerator. So it will be minus 9 and 20, and remaining elements will be as it is, minus 3 and 4. So if you will solve these two determinants and take ratio of these, you will get the value of V1. Now, how to solve this determinant? It is minus 9 into 4. So, minus 9 into 4. I'll write it element wise so that you will come to understand it easily. So, minus 9 into 4 minus this minus 3 into 20. This is numerator. For denominator, 6 into 4. I'll write 6 into 4 minus minus 3 into minus 2. So, this is equal to minus 36 minus of minus. So, it will become plus 60 divided by 24 minus this 3 into 2 minus or minus 3 minus 2 will become plus 6 and minus, so minus 6. Okay, so that is equal to 24 divided by 18. So it is coming out as 1.33 volts. So this is value of V1. For V2, V2 value, it is given by V2 is equal to the same thing at denominator, the same matrix, determinant, 6, minus 2, minus 3, 4, and at numerator, now since this is for second variable, you have to replace the second column by the constants. First column will remain as it is. So that is 6, minus 2, minus 9 and 20. Again solve this. Now 6 into 20 minus minus 9 into minus 2. So it is 120 minus 9 into 2, 18, this will become plus, so 18 divided by, denominator will remain same, it is 18, so it is equal to 102 divided by 18, so it is coming it out as 5.667 volts. So this is the value of V2. We have got the same results of V1. If we have solved it simultaneously, V1 was 1.33, here also V1 is 1.33, V2 was 5.667, here also we have got 5.667. So both the methods have given me the same results. Now I'll solve this with the help of calculator. So if you want to solve it by calculator, we have to change the mode. So in mode, I'll press it once. So this will be the result. I'll press it again. So this will be the result and I'll press it once more. So now I have got this equation in first, matrices in two and VCT in three. So I want to solve equation. So I'll press one. After pressing, it is asking that how many unknowns are there, two or three? My unknowns are two because only V1 and V2 are the unknowns. Now, he is asking A1. A1 is the coefficient of V1 in first equation. So, coefficient of V1 in first equation is 6. So, I'll press here 6. Then equal to, what is B2? B1, it is the coefficient of V2, it is minus 3, so I will write here minus 3 equal to, is asking about C1, that is the constant term in first equation, it is minus 9, so minus 9 equal to A2, that is for second equation, what is the value of, what is the coefficient of first variable, that is V1. So it is minus 2. I'll write here minus 2. Then again equal to, so B2, that is coefficient of V2, it is 4. And equal to C2, it is constant term 20, and equal to, I have got first variable answer, that is V1 is equal to 1.333. So V1 is equal to 1.333, and V2, I'll press it again, once I'll press equal, so it will give me second variable V2, it is coming as 5.667. So by all three methods, I have got the same results, V1 as 1.33 volts and V2 as 5.667 volts. Now, till this, we have computed only V1 and V2. So, what is asked in the question? Using node analysis, calculate current through 3 ohm resistor. So we want to find current through 3 ohm resistor. It is nothing but the I2. And how we have calculated I2 in first equation? This was I1, this was I2. So it is V1 by 3. Or from this also you can find V1 minus 0 divided by 3 is the value of I2 or current flowing through 3 ohm resistor. So I'll write it as I in 3 ohm resistor, it is equal to I2, it is equal to V1 minus 0 divided by 3, and value of V1, I have computed it by all the methods as 1.333 volts. So 1.333 divided by 3, and it will give me the answer as 0.44 amperes. So this is the current flowing through this particular resistor. Now let us